And we're taking a look at a mixed picture in the stock market this morning as investors look for any clarity on the Fed's policy pathway forward, with more insight coming in the FOMC minutes. Those are due out Wednesday. So how should you prepare your portfolio for a market that isn't exactly sure where rates are heading in totality? Here to help weigh in, we've got Adam Coons, Winthrop Capital Management, Chief Investment Officer. Adam, great to have you here. To the extent that your crystal ball is working right now, mine's in the shop. What are you expecting at that next FOMC meeting? Is it continuation of 50 basis points, or is it 25 basis points, as the most recent jobs report would certainly put some cold water on that 50 basis point expectation?
Yeah, certainly the data is making it difficult to know what the next move is going to be, because while the jobs number was better than expected, on the flip side, we also know that revisions lately have been significantly to the downside. And my guess is that's probably what we'll see a continuation of. So the Fed's in a tough place, and I think they're still going to try to kind of feather this softly. I think the 50 basis points out of the gate was a good move to just kind of start this, I guess, end of the tightening cycle. I'm not going to say that this is necessarily loosening. So I think that what they're going to do is play it safe and go with a smaller cut. I think in our opinion, we're probably going to get a 25 basis point cut, and that will be it for the rest of 2025. Now, like you said, my crystal ball is a little bit fuzzy as well. So when we're trying to make that prediction and we're positioning portfolios, we're doing it with a more defensive tilt. Obviously, there's a lot of things, a lot of ingredients in the soup right now. When you look at it, we've got Fed policy, we've got an election, and then there's a lot of global issues going on that, you know, could be black swan events. And so I think taking a more defensive tilt heading into year end is a good bet. You obviously have had a great run in equities, S&P 500 up, you know, 20% or so. So you've had a great year. Now's the time to take a few chips off the table. I'm not saying move away from equities, but just go into a lower volatility, a higher quality, like I said, a more defensive kind of positioning within your portfolio right now.
What do you anticipate the most significant of the black swan events is?
That's difficult. I mean, look, if the Fed disappoints markets and doesn't cut at all, or even the 25 basis point could be considered a little bit disappointing. Part of it is what the reason for that, you know, lighter move would be. That could be a big impact on markets. But obviously, the geopolitical issues, I think, are the biggest black swan potential. Is you know, really the biggest one is what's going on in the Middle East. And so I think if we saw further escalation there that could draw in other countries, that's where, you know, that kind of thing that's, and that's really difficult to position a portfolio for that kind of black swan. But that's what I would say is probably the, you know, the biggest thing that could happen heading into year end.
And if that were to play out, does that just mean a double down on defensive, as you were mentioning a moment ago?
Yeah, I mean, and further that, I think you would really want to look at your fixed income portion of your portfolio, because if you're really trying to protect against those type of events, you want to be in a higher quality, maybe a higher allocation to your fixed income. That is one thing we're doing, and we're actually looking at longer duration, you know, longer maturity type fixed income to lock in rates, because if we did see that, that usually leads to what's called a flight to quality. And so you would see a lot of buyers, especially globally, of U.S. Treasuries if we did see an escalation like that. So we actually are positioning portfolios to increase our allocation to 10 and 30-year U.S. Treasuries through something like an ETF like TLT would be a good example of a way to position that way.
Just lastly, while we have you here, Q3 earnings season, what do you anticipate the broader theme that could prevail might be?
It's all about, you know, the look forward. I think the actual earnings this quarter are going to be a kind of a non-event. The revisions to earnings have been to the downside since midsummer. So I think the bar is pretty low. So, like I said, I think it's less about what happens with the release of these earnings and more about what companies are saying about their what they see in the fourth quarter, what the consumer looks to be doing, their habits, their behaviors, and whether the inventories are going to be in excess, meaning that they're going to have to lower prices. So it's really going to be all about that look forward to the fourth quarter and the kind of holiday shopping season and what corporate America sees kind of around the corner.
Adam Coons, Winthrop Capital Management Chief Investment Officer. Adam, great to see you. Thanks so much for taking the time here with us today.